Hey, you're watching CoolAznTutorials, and today we're going to learn how to do a corkscrew from tricking prodigy Max Lee.
The corkscrew is a fairly advanced tricking move, and I suggest you learn some prerequisites first before you attempt this move. Some prerequisites you might want to learn are a gainer and a decent understanding of the full twist. The corkscrew is a flip and a twist. Many people think the cork is just a sum of the B-twist and a cheek gainer, but it's actually the sum of a gainer and a full twist. So the first thing you should do is warm up and stretch. And by warming up, you can like run around a little bit, jog in place, stuff like that. But for stretching, here's a few stretches I like to do. It's good to stretch both legs, but try to emphasize more on the kick leg, the one you're gonna swing up. The swing of the leg just takes a lot of force, and if you don't stretch, you might pull a muscle or something. So, I like to stretch like this, grab my toe for around 10 seconds. The stretch I like to do is the longer stretch, which is like this, and hold this for 10 seconds. The reason why you have to stretch this muscle is because when you're doing the twist in the corkscrew, you have to keep your legs together in order to spin efficiently. After you're stretched and warmed up, we can learn how to properly set up for the corkscrew. The setup I'm going to teach today is called the J-step. The J-step is very simple. Basically, you're going to imagine a J on the ground, a bigger J. You're just going to walk, and your third step is going to be the curve of that J. And that's where you're going to take off. So now we can move on to the takeoff of the corkscrew. The takeoff is at the curve of your J-step. So try to only take off on your toes, because if you let your heels touch, that's gonna slow you down when you jump. So when you jump, you wanna take off relatively fast, because in tricks, speed equals height, pretty much. So when you're running at that J-step, you wanna basically explode off of that toe. So when you swing the leg, you wanna make sure you swing hard. Swing upwards and hard, because the swing is basically what gets you around for the flip part. So now I'm going to explain the twisting technique for the cork. When you're up here, and after you jumped and your toes are off the ground, you can start the twist when your leg is up here. So when you're twisting, you want to bring, well, first of all, you want to swing your arms up. I forgot to mention that earlier, but you want to elbow one side of your body and wrap in your other arm. So when you're twisting, the first thing you want to make sure of is you want your head looking the way you twist. Because when your arms and legs are twisting this way and you're looking this way, your twisting forces will counteract and you'll just fall and hurt yourself probably. So things you want to make sure of when you're twisting, your head's in motion and your arms are in motion and your knees are in motion. Also, I think it would help for you to tighten your abs when you twist. So the landing for the corkscrew is when you open up from your twisting and just land on 2 feet. Eventually, if you want to challenge yourself, you can land on 1 foot and swing yourself, your other leg, into another cork or a gainer or something like that. But that's only for advanced games. When you put it together, it should look something like this. So that's basically how you properly perform a corkscrew. Be sure you have your prerequisite down, like really good first before you try a corkscrew, because it's easy to get hurt if you don't have the basics down. So with nothing else to say, shout out to Cool Asian Tutorials and peace.